All right, AWF fans, it's ladder match time between the BFF Bearded Friends Forever and the Tag Team Champions, Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt. You see, coming out first, the Bearded Friends Forever, the challengers, making their way to the ring. Special treat tonight, we have the owner of the Arizona Wrestling Federation, Jared Devitt, with us to provide some insight as to why and how this match was actually made and how this came to be.
Thank you, Mr. Anders. And absolutely, this is such a significant, such an important match between the Bearded Friends Forever and the champions, Aydan Colt and Adrian Hawkins. Now, these guys have been battling for the last 6 months in these grueling tag team matches. If you recall, Bearded Friends Forever, back at last Overdrive in August, captured tag team champion. But this past November, in the rematch, Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt not only took away their titles by defeating them, but then they launched into the vicious post-match attack, beating up the Bearded Friends Forever with laughter. Enough was enough. I decided to be settled once and for all. So this past December, I created this ladder.
Yep, and it'll either be these men that you see here, the Bearded Friends Forever, or the current champions, Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt, almost a once-and-for-all type scenario that we have played out here tonight. And it'll be interesting to see if there is still a toll from that vicious, vicious attack that was put on the Bearded Friends Forever, to see if they, in fact, will be able to fight to up to their normal caliber here tonight in this tag match, in this ladder match here tonight.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, they were taken out in the last Arizona Wrestling Federation event. They weren't here due to those sustained injuries. A lot of bad blood between these two teams. You know, they're so evenly matched as well. They've created victories, of course. So this is going to be an absolute war.
Yep, and the Bearded Friends Forever have been medically cleared for this match, so that's why we've gotten the go-ahead, and they've upped the stakes and upped the ante right away, I would have to say, going directly into a ladder match here tonight against these men, the champions, Aydan Colt and Adrian Hawkins. You see Spray Boy, bro, oh, and Big Duke with an attack up the rampway. We're getting this started right now. The Bearded Friends Forever and Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt, they're fighting up the rampway. The action has spilled over into the crowd, almost into the back here on the stage area. Stray Boy Roy has vanished from the set, running lead, almost, if you will, the attack for the Bearded Friends Forever.
Yeah, this is getting pretty hectic. The chaos has started very early. Early on between these teams, I knew that this would just be an all-out brawl, so.
Yeah, it looks like Adrian Hawkins might be making his way back to the ring with Big Duke, Aydan Colt, and Suede Thompson fighting their way towards concession. Oh, right into the men's room, it looks like. It looks like they're going to take this up and down the rampways all around the arena. This may be one of the wildest matches that the AWF has ever seen. We might be in store for a doozy here. Very true, and that may be, as it has been time and time again, one of the big advantages that Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt have, because Spray Boy Roy can and more than likely will get involved, and there's nothing that the Bearded Friends Forever can do about it, because this ladder match is no disqualification. The only way to win is to climb the ladder and get the tag team titles that are suspended high above the AWF ring. And if Spray Boy Roy happens to get involved, the Bearded Friends Forever just have to make sure that they're accounting for him and have their heads to keep an eye on him at all times. He takes him right into the pole. That might put Suede Thompson down for just a bit. Big Duke, already seemingly to have eyes on Spray Boy Roy, takes Adrian Hawkins over to the crowd. Oh, a big chop across the chest. to Adrian Hawkins, and he is feeling that. Big Duke getting the praise from the crowd. You see Adrian there feeling the effects of that big, big hand from Big Duke to the chest. Now Aydan Colt and Suede Thompson still going at it on the outside of the ring, choking Aydan Colt, choking him with the bottom rope, it looks like. The referee can do nothing but just sort of look on and wait for a man to grab the belt from the ladder.
Yeah, it looks like Hawkins.
They're using ear. And this is the matchup that is so intensely personal between these two. As you said, back in August at Overdrive, these two teams had a battle, and they have done so multiple times here in all of their encounters in the AWF, much to the praise of a lot of the fans. But this is intensely personal, and these two teams want to decide here tonight who, in fact, the best tag team in the AWF is, and that'll be proven. But until then, they want to make a point, and they want it to be definitive as to which team is the better team. Adrian Hawkins taking Suede into the ring now. There's no ladder in there, so they don't seem to quite be going for the belts just yet. It looks like Adrian may want to inflict a little bit more pain, working Suede over to the corner, and a big snap suplex. Suede Thompson is definitely feeling that one. Big Duke into the pole with Aydan on the outside. Ooh, and a big kick to the back from Suede Thompson. There you see the AWF tag team title suspended above the ring. Oh, and Big Duke seems to have caught Aydan here. What does he have in store? Oh, his back directly into that steel post. Oh, and drops him right on the apron. And that apron is the hardest part of the ring there, Garrett. Mr. Devitt.
It certainly is here. Now, as you see here, Big Duke having a little bit of fun. They're trying to capacitate the other team. They're really, as you can see here, neither team going for the ladder yet. They're just executing these moves to just make sure that no matter what, they're able to
Big Duke with
them down to go after the ladder. Duke is going crazy with the back breaks here.
He raked an official, and under normal terms and guidelines, you would have to take some sort of action. But here tonight, is that sort of thing flies because there's no disqualification.
It is no disqualification.
Repercussions for Big Duke.
Yeah, I definitely that's definitely not something that we want to see. Certainly, I think just the environment and the mood certainly just got the better of Big Duke.
Not going after. Okay, Aydan was hiding in the fans. It scared me for just a bit there, but it looks like Big Duke had an eye for Aydan Colt, plucked him right out of the audience there. Them getting up close and personal. Adrian seems to have taken back Big Duke, and Colt seems to have been able to evade narrowly.
Yeah, Colt was trying to hide him.
Adrian Hawkins, it looks like, could he be... What's he thinking about here? Has Duke down on the outside. Oh, and a big stomp to the... It looked like the lower stomach, but even if he did get it a little bit lower, this is no disqualification. All the referee can do is check on Big Duke and make sure he can continue. Big Duke going to be grabbing
there. Crazy DDT. It looks like a Suede DDT.
Right off the wall, almost a parkour style tornado DDT. Big Duke with the crutch. Is that the fan's crutch? I think he might have grabbed. It's certainly not his. I think I'm not quite sure. We might want to. The referees, officials seem to be tending to Aydan Colt. Suede seems to be back up. Colt is still down from that humongous tornado DDT off of the wall on the outside. Adrian's checking on and seems to be dragging him away. And I'm not quite sure. We might want to. Okay, Aydan seems to be back up to his feet. Are they retreating? Are the champions retreating?
Duke and Suede, I mean, they might be regrouping a little bit. It might not be a bad strategy on the champions. I see here Hawkins got the team circled up to try to...
Looks like they may have sort of a meeting of the minds, if you will, to try to strategize. But Big Duke, the Bearded Friends Forever, in closing quickly. Spray Boy Roy just narrowly escaping the big, big meaty paws of Big Duke. And Suede seems to be punching around. He might have got knocked senseless from Adrian Hawkins, and throws Big Duke right into Suede on the rampway there. And that seems to That seems to have, whatever strategy, whatever they were going over in that meeting, they seem to, now just Adrian adding insult to injury here, but whatever brief meeting they have seems to be working here, Mr. Devlin.
Certainly using, you know, Duke's momentum there, making sure they take out Suede, and they're right battling on the entrance way here. They're really, like I said, trying to incapacitate someone. I mean, there's no padding out there. This is a very dangerous situation here. If you see Hawkins hitting Duke right in front of that fan over there.
In front of that young lady, and you're absolutely correct. There is nothing on the floor but concrete. There is steel in the post, which they've utilized already many times within this match. And the only difference between this and a typical match is the introduction of all of the steel of the ladders that are scattered throughout this arena.
And
speaking of, Aydan Colt dragging one of those said ladders into the ring. And now the steel has been introduced to the match, and this is what the people paid to see here tonight. Adrian Hawkins setting up that ladder. This could be over here tonight.
Yeah, huge opportunity. He just needs to climb that ladder, get that belt, and the Tag Team Champions retain.
Looks like Adrian making his way up. Big Duke getting to his feet, but Aydan Colt on the outside. Oh, and now the double team into the corner to try to immobilize, which is the big strategy. Oh, and Big Duke right into that ladder. That ladder might be out of commission with as hard as Duke just went through that ladder.
Yeah, they whipped him through that ladder. He hit head first there. I mean, both Duke and that ladder might be caught. I mean,
there is a very good possibility. Aydan Colt seeming to pick and pick his way through the carnage, but that might be out of commission. And Big Duke, the officials may want to check on him. They can't quite end this, but they can at least make sure the man is upright and able to repeat his own name, essentially. Aydan Colt has evil intentions, possibly, with that loud face first right into the ladder. Suede Thompson goes.
Whoa.
And Big Duke with the suplex into the ladder from Adrian Hawkins, and the Tag Team Champions really, really putting on display here tonight just what's won them the gold, and that sort of ruthless nature that they have, really showcasing just why they're champions.
These guys are two-time tag team champions. I mean, they're just taking it to Suede and Duke here. That was a killer. I mean, she flexed here. It looks like Colt set him up.
A snap mirror onto the ladder from Aydan Colt. He seems to be signaling to Adrian. They wanna go after something, and it looks devious. It may involve the second ladder. I'm not quite sure what they have in mind. Suede laid out. Oh, and the ladder, all of that weight of that steel, and that's enough weight. There's enough steel on there to support two men climbing up it. And it all came pouring down right on the chest and the stomach of Suede Thompson.
Don't forget, Suede was essentially on top of that other ladder, too. So he just got sandwiched between all that steel. So as we see Hawkins, you know, just laying that beat down here, attacking the back.
It's almost scientific. It's so calculated how they're going about this attack right now. They seem to be... right on track with whatever stratagem they had coming into this match. And the BFFs, they may have met their match. This may not be their night.
Yeah, the challengers are surprised. Right now, Colton Hawk is really just set up that ladder for him to get the title. So we see Duke is starting to score.
And this is where, as we were saying earlier, with such an intense personal rivalry, this may be where the BFFs can regain their opportunity and regain some sort of momentum in the match. Big Duke seemingly, I'm attempting to do so right now, but the fact that this is such a personal and intense rivalry, does that perhaps hinder the champions from, as you stated, climbing right up the ladder because they want to inflict pain? Does that perhaps give some sort of advantage here?
Yeah, I mean, certainly, and we see right now really regain control.
There's a ladder right to the face. Aydan Colt trying to take any sort of momentum, but Suede Thompson now with the big boot. This is almost a momentum tug of war, or hot potato, if you will. It seems to be bouncing back and forth. Adrian pull Adrian Hawkins and Suede Thompson now. Oh, whipping directly to that ladder. Reverses it, and Adrian Hawkins goes back first into that ladder. Spray Boy Roy can do nothing but encourage it and spray on the outside. I'm not sure if there's some sort of healing ointment in that bottle, but Suede Thompson and Big Duke now setting up the ladder. Look to be taking advantage of it. I'm not sure that one might be out of commission, or we may be going back to the point that we've been making time and time again. They have a perfect opportunity to climb up the ladder on a hip toss onto the ladder and a double elbow from the challengers, but we'll be right back. We're going to take a quick commercial break.
If you have what it takes to be a professional wrestler, prove it at the AWF Academy. The AWF trainers have the tools, knowledge, and experience, including with WWE, to set you down the right path in the professional wrestling world. Visit ArizonaWrestlingFederation.com/academy for more information. AWF Academy, train like a champion.
Folks, we are back, and the action has intensified. All four men have been taking it to each other, and Suede Thompson, who had disappeared into the back, has returned with maybe, potentially, the biggest ladder in the entire AWF arena. It seems to be at least two, if not three times, the size of Suede Thompson himself.
Yeah, it's a substantially bigger ladder, certainly, than the ones that's already been introduced here. And this ladder looks, even more vicious here. So as we...
Oh, and Adrian Hawkins with a dropkick into Suede Thompson. He's seeming to be, I'm not quite sure if he was pinned or whatnot. He seems to be stunned or dazed. Aydan Colt catching a big boot from Big Duke. And all four men are seem to be, it is wearing on them. The effects of this match. Big Duke with the running with the knee to Adrian Hawkins, and oh no, he couldn't be thinking about some sort of power bomb or some sort of maneuver onto that ladder, could he? Adrian Hawkins is in dire. Oh, and Aydan Colt with a punch to the back, and oh, Big Duke takes a big drop with a back body drop from Adrian Hawkins onto that ladder, onto that steel, onto the outside, and rolls out to the concrete.
He may be just injured with that. That was a brutal backdrop. I mean, he just got hit with that huge elbow by Colt, backdrop by Hawkins onto the concrete.
This may be one of the most brutal, intense. Oh, and a big face buster from Suede Thompson, and a kick back onto the ladder. Adrian Hawkins now falling onto that ladder, and a big dive, suicide dive, from Suede Thompson onto the ladder with Adrian Hawkins, a human being sandwiched in between that steel and flesh, spilled out to the outside. And is there some point that we look at this match, and this is by far the most brutal match we've ever seen in this building? Is there any point to where we look at these men and say enough is enough, or somebody's going to have to climb up that ladder and get those tag team champions?
At this point, really. And these guys want it. These guys want to be tag team champions. These guys have had some of the best matches, in the Arizona Wrestling Federation. So there's no way any four of them want this match to certainly be over. They're going to battle until someone's able to grab one of those ladders.
This is absolutely true. And all four of these men are men who will never say die, and Spray Boy Roy, the only man left standing right now.
Spray Boy Roy looks like he... Oh no.
Wait
what's,
a minute.
What's
he seems
doing
to
over
be
here?
Eyeing the title, the championship belt, and grabbing a ladder. Now Spray Boy Roy climbs up there? Is this sanctioned? Will this in fact count? Can Spray Boy Roy win the tag team championship for Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt?
I definitely put this match together, but I don't even know if this was fully... But I'll be honest, this is insane. Here we go. Spray Boy Roy, who's
the ladder. Every man is down. Every man is on.
Spray Boy Roy, his fingertips. He's touching that belt.
And Big Duke. Oh, wait a minute. He may have been in for just a little bit more than he bargained for. Spray Boy Roy working his way down the ladder. And Big Duke is not amused, nor is he a fan of Spray Boy and his antics.
And Spray Boy Roy's definitely trying to back away and get out of this predicament here.
He's trying to negotiate in a big hand to the face, and I think the Bearded Friends Forever, this has been such an intense and personal rivalry that these two teams have had, and Spray Boy Roy being the center of a lot of well, cheating, for lack of a better phrase. He may have just slid through. He was setting him up for a suplex onto the... Oh, now Duke has him firmly in grasp, and he might be going down onto the ladder. Oh, face first into the corner. Suede picks him up. And the big boot into the face on the ladder. I believe he landed on the ladder, and Spray Boy Roy, we may need to get somebody out here for him. He's not a wrestler.
Spray Boy Roy, he might be going to be finished. They hit their double team finishing move. Duke getting that kick off the lift, and then Spray Boy Roy now taken out of commission, and right now it's back to 2-on-2.
And Big Duke seems to be getting some chairs gathered in the corner, and Spray Boy Roy being escorted out by security here, and antics aside, annoyingness aside, Spray Boy Roy is not a wrestler, at least as far as we know, and he has just been taken out, so we'll keep an eye on him. And ensure his safety, because love him or hate him, he is a member of this AWF roster. But Suede Thompson now back to the action. Suede Thompson seems to be setting up the ladder on the outside. I'm not quite sure what he's going to do with it out there, because he's a good distance from the title, hanging over the center of the ring. And
yeah, I think he's got some.
Wait a minute. Adrian Hawkins plucks him right off the top rope, brings him and flips him back into the center of the ring. And I'm not sure how Suede Thompson, he's still standing, but just barely. It may just be momentum holding him up.
Yeah, he hit him with a huge suplex, sending him really from one side of the ring to the other here.
Oh, and Aydan Colt there, then taking him off the apron. Big Duke back in the ring, and Adrian Hawkins feeling the strength and weight of that ladder right across his back. Unsuspectingly, he is down and out, and Big Duke setting it up to go to the top and grab those tag team championships. Adrian Hawkins still defending the home front, though, and defending against Big Duke, ensuring that they remain tag team champions. And it looks like Suede and Colt may be fighting to the back. We'll try to get a camera back there. Our cameras are at ringside, but we'll try to get one back there just to see where they are. But for the time being, Adrian Hawkins and Big Duke now turn into almost a one-on-one singles competition, and a true one at that. There's no more Spray Boy Roy at ringside. Aydan Colt and Suede Thompson have been from elsewhere. Now it's just Adrian Hawkins and the ladders in the ring are the only standing.
Yeah, that's right. And here Hawkins is climbing the ladder. It looks like he's thrown that other ladder at Duke.
And
right now
Adrian Hawkins
is a foot away from that belt. I mean, he's got to just reach up. And
he just dropped that ladder. He is a man of a good 6 feet. Climbing up a few rungs on the ladder and just dropped
his
entire ladder.
Oh,
and Big Duke taking that ladder and hurling it upwards towards the heavens, right in the face of Adrian Hawkins, knocking him off the ladder. And there you see the official checking on him. This may be it. We may have new champions here tonight.
Yeah, Big Duke, that was a desperation throw here. Hawkins, his fingertips away from the belt. Duke couldn't reach him in time. Like, he's able to throw that ladder and smash Hawkins right in the face. So, and now he's got that big ladder here. I mean, Duke's a tall guy. I don't know if he necessarily needs it, but he's going to use that for further punishment.
Perhaps a bigger ladder for Big Duke, if you will.
Right.
Big Duke seems to, once again, I'm not, both teams obviously want the tag team champions and to prove, but they want this to be a very, very definitive which team is the better team. And now Big Duke seemingly out to inflict pain, and a big splash onto the ladder with Adrian Hawkins in between. And I'm not quite sure how much more abuse Adrian Hawkins specifically can withstand being sandwiched in between those steel ladders. This has to be the third or fourth time for him tonight,
and Duke,
he's still standing.
Yeah, Duke also put his own body on the line. You can see how much he wants to be tag team champion. I mean, that's got to do some damage to Duke's ribs. As you see here, he was grabbing it.
He has sacrificed his own body time and time again, and this could be his chance. But for the Bearded Friends Forever to regain tag team goal. Wait a minute, the back door of the arena has been, the officials are, that Aydan Colt And Suede Thompson have seemed to have found their way back to ringside by means of a lot different manner than they exited it. They seem to have been fighting through the parking lot. We didn't get a camera out there, but they're back ringside. Adrian Hawkins and Big Duke going at it once again in the ring. And this place has just come unglued with the fighting, the action on the outside. Suede seems to have a trash can. There you see it just on the side there. It's hard to keep track. Action filled out the AWF arena.
It's definitely made. Hawkins got the Duke set up in that tree of woe. Oh man, if he hits this. He's on the opposite corner over here. What is he doing?
He could have been thinking. You don't think. Adrian Hawkins keeping his balance and since have regained it. And oh no. He's going for it. Oh, and a big drop kick coast to coast. Adrian Hawkins just connected that chair to Big Duke's face.
Went from one side of the ring all the way to the other, driving that steel chair right into Duke's head. Duke might be done here. I mean, Hawkins is pretty spent, but if Hawkins can get up right now, I mean, he's got that opportunity, but it looks like Suede's up as well here.
And that may be all she wrote for Big Duke, but Suede taking the fight to Aydan Colt now with that trash can. Up, seems to place it over. Aydan Colt is trapped more or less, and he's got the ladder in almost a helicopter motion, taking out Aydan Colt and Adrian Hawkins, and he is just spinning wildly. Suede Thompson in the center of the ring.
Airplane spin with the ladder here, and oh, did take out both.
It seems to be a little dizzy from all of that airplane spinning, but. If there's one thing that he can realign and he does know is exactly where those belts are hung.
As we see here, Suede and Duke have that opportunity now to get that ladder.
Suede Thompson setting up the ladders in the middle of the ring. Well, he only needs
two up.
He only needs one, but setting up two right now, I'm not quite sure what he has in mind. Big Duke crawling back in the shot. It looks like he may be... Maybe ensuring that his partner has.
So it looks like Hawkins is looking back up.
Oh, Suede Thompson able to kick him off. Aydan Colt now going after Suede. And oh, I'm not quite sure who got the worst of that one, but Suede looks like Suede did.
And now Duke is back to be the only guy up, and he's got the ladder right in the middle. Duke's just got to climb that ladder and retrieve those belts.
And if Duke can do that, it looks like he may be uncontested in doing so. Oh, Adrian Hawkins jumping off the middle rope connects with that trademark elbow right to the face of Big Duke, and now all men are down. Everybody is on the mat except Adrian Hawkins popping back up, and this may be, once again, an opportunity that they have to capture and maintain the championship, the AWF as tag team champions, but Adrian Hawkins doesn't seem to be going about that. He should be going directly up the ladder, but they are intent on inflicting pain.
Yeah, Hawkins is setting up. I mean, we're seeing Adrian Hawkins kind of bust out with a lot of stuff he generally doesn't do here. Look at this.
And a springboard moonsault off of the second rope. Big Duke rolls out of the way, and Adrian Hawkins catches nothing but steel.
Yeah, that's face first move. Face first impact right on that ladder from that.
Oh, and Suede Thompson with a big 450 splash onto Adrian Hawkins, capitalizing on that missed moonsault. And Suede Thompson has taken out Adrian Hawkins at least for the time being. And it's Suede Thompson and Big Duke now, if they can regain composure, set up the ladder in the middle of the ring, we may hit a new tag team championship.
Yeah, certainly are. It looks like they're both grabbing the ladder. They got Colt in the corner here.
Oh, he narrowly avoids it. Oh, and tries to leap over. They catch him. Oh, now insult to injury, driving it in just a bit more into the lower extremities of Aydan Colt, and that might be enough. They may do it. We may have new AWF Tag Team Champions here tonight if they can get up that ladder.
That's definitely a huge difference maker. That's going to take out Colt for some time here. He's going to be feeling bad, and now the champion, or the challengers, that is, right back in control. Champions are out. Duke's trying to get the fans behind it right now. He just got a belt, and it looks like they're both climbing the ladders.
And I think everybody in the building just realized that we could very well see the Bearded Friends Forever become champions tonight, but Adrian Hawkins back up and clinging, hurling Big Duke out of the ring, pulling Suede down off the ladder. Adrian with a big, big right hand, and with another big, nasty drop kick to Big Duke, and sends Duke to the outside into the AWF Fan Nation. It was almost in desperation, but very quickly, almost in the heartbeat, the momentum is swayed, and it's swayed now right back to Suede Thompson with a big knee to the face of Aydan Colt. Aydan Colt rolling back all the way across the ring, and once Suede Thompson is the last man standing.
We might get the belts here after that injury and knee to the face, but it looks like Hawkins is coming up right behind. I don't know what.
Oh, now this is getting dangerous. Right, yes, it is. And both men at the top of the ladder right now. No, you don't think Adrian Hawkins could be thinking about... Oh!
Yeah, he just hit that unprettier
the
on
unpretty,
him.
And that is Adrian Hawkins' finishing maneuver. Deadly when done in the middle of the ring. And this was from...
Suede's lights are on. I don't think anyone's home right now. That unprettier. That puts out guys. In the ring itself, I mean,
top of the ladder, high in the close to the roof of the AWF arena.
Right. I mean, he's especially the position of his head, 10 feet up, just smashing right into the ground here. I think
Adrian Hawkins, this may be enough to regain to keep the tag team titles for the champions, but Big Duke once again making the save and stopping Adrian Hawkins just in the nick of time, pulling him down off of that ladder. And Duke maybe, what's he going for here? Oh, just hangs him out to dry in the corner here. Big Duke, if he sets up that ladder once again so quickly in this match, can the momentum change? And now it's Big Duke, the only man standing right now with the opportunity to gain the tag team championship.
And Duke is fingertips away from the thing. And a steel chair by Colt right in the face.
Right in the cranium. And Big Duke is out cold.
Yeah, Colt Aydan dropped him cold with the shot. It looks like Colt's going to, if Colt can climb those ladders, they're going to retain those tag team champions. But Suede and Duke are out.
Suede and Duke are out cold. Suede is nowhere to be seen. Big Duke, you see on the bottom of your screen there, just took that chair shot to the head. Aydan Colt making his way to the top of the ladder is Adrian Hawkins at his flank. And
oh, wow, he's
grabbing for those belts. It looks like he may have
he's got it on the hook.
And he's got to get that second one down to be official, and he's working on it. But it looks like we have new tag team, or no, the same
right.
Tag team champions. They've retained their champ titles. Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt are your winners tonight. And with this hard-fought battle kick, what... was this the expectation when you set the match?
I think so. I mean, these guys were fighting to prove who was the best tag team. I think the real winners of this match were the AWF Fan Nation. This wonderful great match. Hell of a battle. I mean, really, there's no losers here. I mean, the big winners tonight, it's Aydan Colt and Adrian Hawkins. These guys, I mean, they've earned it. They fought this war. They were able to retain the belts here.
They've left everything in the ring. You just saw two of the best tag teams in the Arizona Wrestling Federation settle the score tonight, and those are your winners. Still, tag team champions Adrian Hawkins and Aydan Colt prove that they, at least for the time being, are in fact the best tag team in the Arizona Wrestling Federation. So for the owner of the Arizona Wrestling Federation, Jared Devitt, and myself, Gabriel Anders, you've just witnessed a war, and the tag team champions have retained. Thank you very much from Glendale, Arizona. We'll see you next time, AWF Fan Nation. Good night.